Hey, Adam Dukes here. Welcome to Dadpreneur episode number 59. Doing it down here at the living room. We just got up the old Christmas tree. We do it the lazy way, just the artificial way, the easy way, I guess I should say. Back in the day, when we were little in Michigan, I remember going out with family, cousins, aunt and uncle, and three of my cousins, and we would go out and go park, walk through a ton of wooded area in the snow, and my dad would cut down the tree. It was a cool way to do things. We always had cats, and the cat would always knock over the tree, so we had like fishing line tied throughout the living room, like four pieces of fishing line like tied around the tree, like up top into the corners of the living room, because the cat would always climb the tree and knock it down. This one, the cat plays with the ornaments. The kids love playing with the ornaments. I wanted to do Dadpreneur down here by the tree in the festive mood. So how do you find U.S. suppliers? This is a question. Someone bought a course of mine, and they emailed me how to find suppliers. This is a pretty common question, so I figured, put this on for a Dadpreneur episode. How do you find U.S. suppliers? How do you find good products? And the other question from someone else was, how do you find good products with still healthy margins? So kind of a couple questions I'm going to cover. The one is, I use Google, and I type in, like, whatever the niche is, plus dropshippers, whatever the niche is, plus wholesalers, whatever the niche is, plus suppliers. The keyword strings kind of like that. If it's like fishing is the niche, then go fishing rods, things like that. You go pick out a product in the specific niche, you know, kind of niche it down. But that's how I've always found things. Sometimes you can search Etsy, you can reach out to those sellers and maybe work out some type of a deal, a partnership, you know, where you use them as the vendor. So you could do that. How to find quality products with good margins. That's what someone else asked me yesterday, shot me an email. A lot of times the people don't put the wholesale pricing on the website. So it's kind of the retail pricing. So you kind of see the retail price and it's like, it's pretty high, you know, and you're like, how am I going to sell this for even more money with my margins? You know, a lot of times that's the retail price. So most of the times you have to sign up for an account. Sometimes you have to be verified. I've signed up for accounts where it's taken 48 hours. They've had to call me on the phone before to verify it. Sometimes you can just sign up for an account right on the website, you know, and be like instantly approved. But most of the time, I think it's, you got to have like your tax ID or your EIN number, the employee identification number, maybe tax ID number. I can't really remember, but some are pretty detailed, you know, like I said, that's a phone verification. And then once you get your account, then you can see, you have to log in and you can see the wholesale pricing, which is typically like 30% less than retail, sometimes up to 50%. But I've found 30 to 35% is kind of the wholesale pricing. 30% less than the retail price. So do that. Like I get a magazine. I still get them. This jewelry magazine, a jewelry company I use. They send me the magazine and it's retail price. And for like the first, I don't know, I get like five magazines a month, it seems like. So anytime I look at it, you know, there's a couple times I forgot it's retail. I'm like, this shit's a ripoff. This stuff's expensive, you know. And then I logged into the account online and realized that, oh, this is what they send to their customers, their customers, you know. So make sure you look for the wholesale price. That's going to make a big difference. So like I said, I use Google to find a niche. I do certain different keywords. And then also I have, there's a link down below. You can buy, I scraped Google and took the time and other websites and pulled off 93 other, majority of these companies are actually all drop shippers here in the United States. Suppliers, again, most of them are drop shippers. I don't want to say every single one, but most of them are drop shippers. There's 93 of them, and I think there's, I can't remember how many officially licensed stuff. So if you want to sell like Star Wars or Major League Baseball, things like that, there's a little more paperwork process to do that, to legally do it, but it's well worth doing it. So click the link below and you can buy that 93 suppliers for I think it's $9.99. It's less than $10. Well worth it. It'll save you a ton of time, money, and frustration. So that is episode number 59 for Dadpreneur TV. Thank you and Merry Christmas.